8 years ago. Oh boy. We're going back to almost, I'm telling you, almost when I was young. 8 years ago. We introduced you to a 13-year-old named Ashley. Now, Ashley's mother, Sharon, came to our show to uncover the truth about her daughter. Because rumor had it that Ashley was not only sexually active, but that she was sleeping with boys in the woods and in barns. And she was also violent. And Ashley's 24-year-old sister, Savannah, had claimed Ashley punched her in the face, gave her a black eye. Watch.
I heard that my daughter had sex with a guy in the barn. My biggest fear is that she might get AIDS. I want my daughter to know that I love her with all my heart, and I would do anything for her.
How'd you hear about this sex in the woods?
My stepdaughter, she told me, she asked her how to give a guy.
I might be 13, but I'm the boss of me. I told one teacher I was gonna beat her ass because she gave me an F. When my sister Savannah rats me out, I'd be the out of. My sister told my mom one of my secrets, and I gave her a black eye.
What happened in the woods?
Nothing.
Nothing?
If it did, does it matter to you?
Yeah. You love your 24-year-old sister?
Yeah.
How does somebody who loves somebody end up beating on her?
Look at your mother! Oh, shut up! Could you be like this to her? After everything that she's done, look at her!
So as you just saw, the situation was tearing apart Sharon's family, and it was time to find out if the rumors about 13-year-old Ashley were true. It was time to reveal the results of the polygraph test. Watch. You were asked, Ashley, if you ever performed sexual favors for marijuana. You're telling me.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You were asked, have you ever had sex in a barn? You said no. The lie detector determined you're telling the truth.
Thank you. Thank you.
You were asked if you ever had sex with a boy. You said no. The lie detector determined that was a lie more than five times. After those results, it was clear that 13-year-old Ashley needed an intervention. So once again, we called on a man who has helped us countless times before, Raphael B. Johnson. Watch.
If you continue to steal, if you continue to smoke dope, you're not going to do well in school, you can't find a job, where are you going to turn to? You're going to live just like those people over there.
Is this a place you want to be at?
No.
You see what he got in his buggy? That's all he got. At the end of the day, the only person that will be there is your family.
As you just saw, it seemed like Raphael planted a seed of change in Ashley's heart, too. But did the seed grow? Or did Ashley succeed in destroying her life? Today, 9 years later, let's see who has returned to give us an update. Nice to see you both.
Good to see you.
I'm so happy to see the both of you.
Oh, it's so good to be here.
Wow, and not only that, how's life, Ashley?
Life is amazing.
You've lost a lot of weight, haven't you?
I have. I've lost 100 pounds.
Wow.
Yes.
And was that all part of turning your life around?
Oh, yes, because I was angry, upset, and after this experience, it was incredible. It changed everything.
Well, let's talk about that. Sharon, what happened after the show?
Ashley saw what could happen with her life. At that point, she told me she was ready to change, and so we enrolled her in sports. She became a basketball all-star.
Everything.
Yeah.
Really? I see you talking so proudly about your daughter.
Yes.
But what about your sister? How's that going?
Oh, it's amazing. We're best friends.
You and your sister are best friends?
Yes.
You ought to tell everybody about your present life.
Like, I have two children. I have a husband. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I work with a mother.
So now, Ashley and Alicia mentioned Raphael, and he was a big part of helping them change. Everybody, here's Raphael B. Johnson.
Thank you.
I get very teary at this because they are two examples of what you do all the time.
What both of you done for Ashley that day has changed her. She has got so much self-esteem now.
And it's because of both of you. It really is.
Let me say this, Maury. None of this would be as it is now if it wasn't for you giving me the opportunity. Okay? So, not only for me to do what I love to do, but what I was born to do. When your executive producer, Paul, reached back out to me 11 years ago, this was something I was already doing. So it wasn't about TV, it wasn't about fortune, it wasn't about fame. It was about really how could I continue to impact young people and try to compensate for the mistakes that I made when I was their age and even younger. And I want to say this to y'all. Life is difficult itself, okay? No one said it would be easy. But let me say this about difficulty. It's necessary, okay? Mm-hmm. It's necessary because it builds character when you struggle, okay? Mm-hmm. It's necessary because it forges you into the women that you are destined to be and not the little girls you were yesterday, okay? There's this thing in life called reciprocity, all right? When people do for you, it's simply you do for others. And so just as Maury reached out and gave me the opportunity and then lent you a helping hand, so too you must reach back with somebody in your school, in your neighborhood, at work, at whatever it may be, lend them a helping hand because they're a less fortunate position. That's how we make the world a better place, and that's how we can change the reality with you.
Alicia, I want to thank you all, you especially, for all that you do with the guests on our show, but not only for our show, the youth in Detroit,
right,
where you live,
yes, sir,
and for all the kids around the country who you help,
mm-hmm,
you're my man.
I really is like the most embarrassing like thing ever.
Do you think that maybe your weight had a lot to do with what you thought about yourself?
My weight had the biggest contribute to me being hateful, angry, starting fights, anything possible to stay away from my feelings.
Because of your attitude, you kind of acted out violently.
Oh, I did. I was very violent.
Somebody said you had sex in a barn.
Yeah, well, it ain't true.
You had to take that lie detector test, didn't you?
You were asked if you ever had sex with a boy. You said no. The lie detector determined that was a lie more than five times.
I did nothing.
When you saw it on TV, do you think that that had an impression in terms of wanting to change your
life? Oh, yes, definitely.
I hear that a lot from a lot of the kids who come on like you. And they say, you know, I didn't think I would change. And then when I saw it, I was so embarrassed. And not only was I embarrassed, all my friends saw it.
Yes, all of them saw it.
All three of you. Thank you so much. I'm so happy you came. Welcome, everyone, to my official YouTube channel. The lie detector test has determined you are in the right place. Make sure to subscribe to get daily updates, watch full segments, and see original content. Until next time, America, see you on YouTube.